Welcome to the adventure on Pipeman on W4CY Radio.
Wake up, America! It's time for the Adventures of Pipeman on W4CY.com, West Palm Beach's number one internet radio station. Here's your host, the Pipeman.
This is the Pipe Man here on the Adventures Pipe Man W4CY Radio, and I'm very excited about our next guest for a couple reasons, because not only great music, but more importantly, some great art, which music is art, and I think, you know, painting type of art and any other type of art goes hand in hand with music. And so let's welcome to the show Michael Cartellone from Lynyrd Skynyrd. How are you?
I'm good, Pipe Man. How are you doing?
I'm doing great. And, you know, I did want to start off with that because you said, I saw somewhere where you said that music and art have always been two halves of a whole. And I have said so many things like that. Like, I think about the old days when you would get an album, not an MP3, but an actual album, and it was a whole sensory experience.
Yeah, truly. You'd sit there with that... with that album cover, 12 inches by 12 inches, and, you know, it's like looking at a painting.
Yeah. Hey, listen, most of the albums I bought were because of the album cover, so the art came first, the music came second.
Yeah, and, you know, it's in a way a shame that the album cover art has been almost kind of forgotten in a way. It's not as part of the full package as it once was.
Yeah, and hopefully it's making a comeback now. Vinyl's making a comeback. And so our studio is here in West Palm Beach. I'm going to be at your show at the I Think Amphitheater right here in West Palm. But then you're also having a showing of your new art at the Wentworth Gallery at the Hard Rock. So tell us more about that.
Right. Well, thank you for bringing that up. So, as you say, on the 21st, we're at the I Think, and that's kicking off our summer tour, which is celebrating the band's 50th anniversary. Of course, in 1973, the Pronounced album was released, so this is a big year of celebration for us. And to commemorate that, I decided to do a painting, which is called 50, and it is a portrait tribute to the seven band members on Pronounced.
Wow.
And this painting will be at the Hard Rock Wentworth Gallery in the Seminole. And people can actually see it now because it's already online. So they could go to wentworthgallery.com and scroll down to my page and you'll see the image there. And we have created 50 signed and numbered canvas prints of this painting that are going to be available. Now, also, another new painting, which I'm very, very proud of, is called Ringo. And it's a tribute to my favorite drummer from my favorite band. And that painting portrays the very famous rooftop concert that was the Beatles' last live performance. And what I wanted to do with this one is I wanted people to see what Ringo saw. So you, the viewer, are Ringo. And the painting is what it looked like that day, sitting behind his drums, looking out over the top of the drums and the cymbals and seeing the other three Beatles there, and then beyond them, the London skyline.
Wow.
And I spent a full year working on that painting because it's big. It's 5 feet across. It has a crazy amount of detail to it. I'm very, very proud of that painting. And that one can also be seen online now, as well as at the Wentworth exhibit on the 20th.
So, first of all, I just want to say that my one of my first favorite bands was the Beatles. And because of Ringo, when I was in first grade, I started playing drums. Of course, I never got as good as you or him. I probably sucked, but he was the reason I got into it. So.
Yeah, well, amen. Right back at you. And, you know, it doesn't matter being the whatever level of skill at a drum kit. It's just about the expression. And yeah. And as is the painting. That's why both of those things are just so integral to my daily life, because I can't imagine doing one without the other.
Right. I think it does go hand in hand. I've said that for a while, and I think that's the part. I think kids today, I hate to sound like that guy, that kids today, but that they're missing out on, because I just remember buying an album, sitting there and just like consuming it, putting my headphones on, looking at every piece of artwork. And, you know, it's interesting. We're going to talk about the detail that you put in your paintings. But what's interesting about that is in relationship to the Beatles, I used to buy all the Beatles albums because of that 1969 radio show where they did the Paul was dead thing. And I used to buy all the albums to find the clues in the artwork. So,
absolutely.
And you, from what I understand, like, that's what you're known for is detail. Like, you study it, like, as if you were there, not just looking
well,
at
well, painting. Truly. And, you know, regarding the Ringo painting, you know, I spent quite a while doing research before I even began painting. And I should mention, Pipe Man, that I had this idea about 15 years ago, and I just kind of filed it away. And then last year, when the Get Back documentary came out, it reminded me of that idea. And I thought, oh, yeah, maybe now's the time to paint this. So I looked at tons of photos. I watched films to really study and get the reference that I needed before I started painting, to the degree that when you see this painting, the drum heads look exactly like they did.
Wow.
That day. They are aged and discolored, and the logo is kind of faded, and the symbols are tarnished. And, you know, I mean, even as far as studying the brick and mortar patterns of the buildings across the street, I went to that degree to truly make it feel like you are there in the moment. Who knows?
Wow.
Maybe one day Ringo will see it and he'll say, yep, that's how it felt.
Well, we'll have to get him to see it.
Sounds good to me.
And so tell us how this journey all started for you, this intertwining road of art and music.
Well, the art actually happened first. My kindergarten teacher had seen that I was really enjoying painting and drawing, and said something to my parents about, you know, they might want to encourage that. And they did. So the summer in between kindergarten and first grade, I was 4 years old, my parents enrolled me in a summer art course at the Cleveland Institute of Art. Cleveland, Ohio is where I'm from. And that started the painting and has never stopped. And then I just studied any course that was offered throughout elementary and high school. And then the drumming began when I was 9. The music interest happened much earlier because my older sisters were playing Beatle records in the house. So that cemented that love very early on. And then when I started drumming at 9, I just realized that I loved both of these things, painting and drumming equally, and just continued to do them both. And I mean, truly, Pipe Man, on any given day, I'm either a drummer who's painting or I'm a painter who's drumming.
I love how
I mean,
you
put I
that.
Cannot separate them in my head.
Oh, I love how you put that. It's so cool. Well, it's all art, isn't it? Like, I think it all goes hand in hand, all of it together. If you're creative,
it truly
it's
does.
Not just one, you know?
It truly does. And you know, there for that reason, there are a lot of musicians who paint. You know, there are a lot of, you know, poets who play instruments. You know, it's just kind of endless, I think.
It's funny, you mentioned poet, and immediately I thought of Jim Morrison, because he never wanted to be a rock star, he wanted to be a poet.
Yeah. You know, I mean, I have a lot of professional athlete friends who are hobbyist musicians. So, you know, that's crossing a line of different expression, but, you know, if you have that within you and you need to express it, you just have to get it out.
I agree, and I think music, art, anything like that is one of the greatest forms of therapy, not only for the person doing it, but for the person that is the one consuming the content, you know? I even think of my dad. He was a painter, but that not for a living, just to escape life. And there were times he would, you could relate to this, he would like not sleep for like 48, 72 hours and like paint straight through.
Yeah, that's incredible. That's incredible. Yeah, it truly is, you know, a way to not only, you know, unplug from life for a minute, but, you know, recharge the batteries. And,
Yeah. You
know, a lot of the paintings that I've done have been while I was sitting in a hotel room during a Skynyrd tour.
Nice.
Because I would carry an easel in and out of hotels and paint during the day. And that was a great way for me just to kind of have some balance.
I thought about too, as you were saying that, it's a great way for you to get into the zone before doing the show. You know, you kind of get out of your head.
Yeah, truly. I mean, I literally have done a few drumming paintings of my vantage point, which is probably where the Ringo painting idea came from. And, you know, while I was working on one of those, you know, drumming vantage points, we would be on stage that night and I would look down at the pedal and go, oh, you know, I didn't get that one bolt in. Oh, shit, I'm in the middle of the show. And, you know, so I would I would literally be living both at the same time.
Oh, man, that's so funny. But it's so true. It's kind of like how I am. That's why I don't edit my own interviews, because if I did, it would take me 2 years.
Yeah, then don't start doing that.
I know, right? Tell us a little bit about the tour starting here in West Palm Beach for Lynyrd Skynyrd. Let's talk about that briefly real quick. I'll be there. I'm sure it'll be a great show as always.
Yeah, we're really excited. Yeah, so we're kicking it off in West Palm.
I love it.
And ZZ Top, of course, are with us all summer, and that's going to be wonderful. And we just spent a week in Nashville rehearsing, creating a whole new show. We've got a different song list that we pulled some classics out of the past that we haven't done in a while.
Wow.
We've got new lighting. We've got new video content. It's a great show. We're very excited this year.
I love it. I can't wait for it. And let's tell everybody how they can, first of all, check your tour dates, because, you know, if they're not here in South Florida, and also, more importantly, check out your art and anywhere that there are other exhibitions besides here in South Florida as well.
Well, for the band, they could just simply go on lynyrdskynyrd.com and get the tour updates there. And for my artwork, you can visit wentworthgallery.com. And Wentworth have about 8 or 9 locations up and down the East Coast. But, you know, the work is also available through the website. And then I have my own art website, which is michaelcartellone.com, where they could see the artwork as well.
Beautiful. And are there any other, well, how do they connect to you on socials, too?
Through the Skynyrd page.
Any final words you want to leave the listeners with that we haven't covered yet that you want them to know?
I would just say thank you for the way everyone has supported Lynyrd Skynyrd's music all of these years. And this is a really important year for us. You know, sadly, we lost Gary Rossington.
Yeah.
So this year is going to be not only a celebration of his life, but a tribute to the band's legacy. So we're really looking forward to a great year.
Yeah, and it just blows my mind. I was talking about this the other day. It blows my mind that I'm even thinking about a 50th anniversary tour for any band.
Yeah, it's really incredible, but it does go to show you that when you have music that is timeless, like these songs are from Lynyrd Skynyrd, people just will always enjoy it. It will always feed them. I know it feeds us, and we get the good fortune to perform it.
I remember my introduction was middle school. My biggest memory of middle school is Lynyrd Skynyrd because of Freebird, obviously. And I remember getting the album One More Four crossed out from the road, you know. And man, it just blows my mind that here we are now in 2023, and we'll get to see you live once again.
Yeah, life is good. Life is good.
Totally. Well, thank you for giving us all the art that you do, both music and the actual artistry from painting. And hey, keep doing it and keep rocking us. Look forward to seeing you here at I Think Amphitheater, and look forward to more art from you. And thanks for being on the Adventures of Pipeman.
Thanks, Pipeman. Hi, everybody. This is Michael Cartellone from Lynyrd Skynyrd, and you are listening to Pipeman on W4CY Radio.
Thank you for listening to the Adventures of Pipeman on W4CY Radio.